I am a teaching-focused lecturer. That means that I spend 80% of my time in teaching-related duties and 20% doing other things. So my career has been quite diverse, very unorthodox. I did my bachelor's in chemical engineering. I graduated with first-class honours and then went on to do my PhD. After that, I did several part-time jobs in research, and then I took 5 years off when my first child was born in 2005. Taking 5 years off was really tough, and it made me wonder if I'd chosen the correct career for myself. But when I applied for a job in late 2010 and got it at the University of Melbourne, all the doubts that I had about whether or not chemical engineering was really my field were dissipated. I absolutely loved going back to work, and it just took off from there, really. When you think about traditional STEM skills, we are really talking about applying maths or physics or chemistry. But when you look at industry graduates and the needs that industry have and how they work collaboratively, you realize that that's not enough. You need to be able to articulate what that brilliant idea was, or how creatively you can solve a problem, or how you can persuade a whole panel of people to give you money. Because that's really what it boils down to, being able to translate your skills into a solution to a problem and then convince other people of how good that is. Technology is evolving, so we're looking at new materials that are being created, new technologies that are surfacing, which are changing the face of engineering as we now know it. So things like, you know, nanomaterials, 3D printing, energy storage will fundamentally change how we do engineering and change the world around us. So that's exciting, because it means that when you graduate in the next few years, if you're thinking about engineering as your career path, then you really have an opportunity to work in a variety of new fields that haven't yet been created or haven't existed up until this point. So things like big data and artificial intelligence, for example, being applied to our fields means that we're going to do things quite differently. And that's exciting. I think that I would tell myself to be a bit more confident and believe in my strengths. I would generally say don't doubt yourself as much as you do. I think we all have a healthy, sometimes unhealthy level of self-doubt, and that can hold us back. Your best job is where your unique skill set matches the requirements of the role. And when you find that, you've already created success for yourself, because that is really who you're meant to be. But also, when you're young, you don't know what your strengths are. Your job should be to discover what those things are. What makes you wake up in the morning and smile and want to do something, and what really does not motivate you. Your job is to discover yourself and use your skills to the best of your ability, and find people to cheer you on.